Thanks for watching UX and Specs, the point of view artifact review, where an artifact, be it physical or digital, is literally reviewed from the user's point of view based on the scenario and tasks of a persona. The star is Tom. Tom's Tom. And me, Tom Peterson, does all the talking. In this review, Nike Plus Running. The Android application allows you to map your runs, track your progress, and post your results to Facebook and Twitter. The persona is Victor Dimitri, a 35-year-old male who is a college graduate and holds a full-time desk job. He lives in the Midwest and uses his phone for work and play. Victor's typical usage includes text messaging, Twitter, Facebook, web search, Instagram, email, music and audiobooks, and calls. Victor's primary goal is to listen to music and audiobooks while running, receive updates on his pace, and log each run in time. The secondary goal is to share run details on Facebook and Twitter. The full persona and scenario are available at uxandspecs.com. Victor's primary goals are pretty straightforward. Listen to something while running and monitor his progress. The first thing he's going to do is launch the application. The device is running Jelly Bean, so an icon was created on one of the home screens. After the splash screen, a summary of Victor's runs are shown. For orientation, the primary screens are locked to portrait, but the setting screens change orientation. The screen that is displayed during the run can be set to portrait or landscape. For Victor's purposes, locked in portrait is fine. The back button operates at the screen level, which brings Victor back to the previous screen. Data retention is excellent. The first time Victor used the application, he had to create a Nike Plus profile. This makes his run details available online and allows use of multiple devices. The secondary goal was to share run details. Nike Plus handles account integration with Facebook and Twitter and allows how much information to share. The sign-in settings are retained, so when the run is complete, Victor only has to tap post. The tap count is minimal, which is excellent. The drop-down navigation menu and options menu in the action bar allows for easy access to everything when not in run mode. When in run mode, Nike Plus shows Victor the distance, time, pace, and his location on a map. The run may be paused or resumed with a tap, but an intentional swipe is required to end the run. The application is designed well for the environment in which it operates. The run prep screens are visible when standing still, and when in motion, the screen displays run progress only or a location on the map with the run progress. Victor has large hands, and the Samsung Galaxy Nexus has a large screen, so on this device, thumb mobility is a stretch. But on smaller devices like the Nexus One, the application is very thumbable. The account integration is outstanding. When the run is complete, just tap Share This Run, and the active accounts are selected by default. The message is optional, and tap Done. Nike Plus Running keeps track of pace using the device's GPS. If the GPS is not active when attempting to start the run, the application lets Victor know and allows him to activate it. He activates all three and agrees to location consent. Tapping back returns him to the application. Victor's primary goals are to listen to music or an audiobook and receive updates while running. Nike Plus doesn't support music on this device, so Victor has to queue up the track, then go back to Nike Plus and start the run.